Good morning. So it is in continuation of the last class where we introduced precharge CMOS logic. I told you that precharge CMOS logic is very good in various respects, but there are certain drawbacks which I was just about to mention at the end of the last class. And I told that today's class I will discuss that. That happens. You know, let us once again talk about this domain, the so-called precharge CMOS. Precharge CMOS in general, therefore, will be like this. That was exactly what a precharge CMOS is, which I discussed in the last class, where, of course, I did not actually present this general one. It was presented either for an inverter or from an AND gate or for a NOR gate. But as I told you, that in general, you can realize any combinational logic using this precharge CMOS concept. Only thing what you have to do is that you have to configure the transistor, the MOSFETs, all N MOSFETs in this F block. We call it F block, the function block. All the transistors are N MOSFETs. They have to be configured in such a way that the desired function F is generated through that so-called pass transistor mode or pass transistor or switch transistor logic. Ultimately, at this particular node, you will get F complement, the inverse of F. In the evaluate phase, this I discussed very clearly, in the evaluate phase. So I told you there are two phases of operation. One is called precharge phase, when phi is zero, is called precharge. And phi is one, is called evaluate. These are the two phases of operation of the precharge CMOS logic. When phi is equal to zero, that means the precharge phase, you remember that this transistor is on, whereas this is off. Therefore, this particular block from this node to VSS, it offers an open circuit, simply because this is off. So we don't have to bother what is happening here. But VDD is on, very strongly on, because phi is zero, which makes the PMOS very heavily on, and as a result, this particular node will be charged to VDD. VDD is which is known as precharge state. We say that before the evaluation mode, before the onset of the evaluation cycle, this particular node should remain at one. That means charged to the fullest voltage. Okay, and during this precharge cycle, you are allowing some time for setting this block to for proper settling this block to the steady state. That means you remember that the various signals in X means a bunch of signals, X, so A, B, C, D, etc. is a word really, N-bit word in general. So they are coming from various places from the chip. Each of them are associated with a delay. And you are allowing some time for the settling down of the functional block F, so that by this time, when the precharge phase is over, the ones and zeros at the inputs of the various transistors are properly established. Then comes the so-called evaluate phase, when phi becomes one. Then this becomes instantaneously off. This becomes instantaneously on. And whatever was the, you know, for the particular combination of input signals, whatever was the total state, either the whole thing may offer an open circuit, or a short circuit for the particular combination of X. If it is open circuit, the same pre-charge state 1 will continue to remain, whereas if the overall situation is such that between this and this is a short circuit, it's a very low resistance state, and because this NMOS being in low resistance state during the evaluate phase, therefore this voltage, whatever it was there, this charge will be discharged fully to VSS and this will come down to zero. That was a thing. I told you that this is otherwise very nice because it is just marginally more, you know, it occupies little bit more space, the corresponding NMOS logic, NMOS static logic, only this extra pair of, maybe this particular transistor and this transistor, they are the only thing. In fact, in NMOS logic also, in place of this PMOS, there was an NMOS, but now there is a PMOS and that's the only extra thing. But then I told that this is very excellent and in every respect this kind of this logic, which is called pre-charge CMOS logic, is very welcome for VLSI implementation. But thereafter, just at the end, I was about to tell that there are certain drawbacks in this. And what are those drawbacks? One drawback is, suppose this output of a particular stage, and there are various crossovers. You know that normally the VLSI is a multi-level metallization scheme is there. So there may be various crossovers like this. In certain places, there may be unfortunately a thing like this also. You do not know. So various lines, metallization line, in certain cases there may be a parallel line, and in certain other cases there may be crossovers, of course with some isolation here, electrical isolation here, dielectric isolation here. Plus, please remember, between the lines, say this I call F1, F bar, so I1, 2 and 3, there are three lines I am showing. Between these three lines, 1, 2, 3, and this A bar, the output line of this, output bus of this particular stage, there is a capacitance. Overlap. This is overlap capacitance, and this is inline. Because two lines are going parallel, there will be some capacitance. And not only capacitance here, there will be some appreciable amount of inductive coupling, mutual coupling in such cases. In these two cases, there will be mostly capacitive or electrostatic coupling, whereas in the other case, there will be not only electrostatic coupling, some electromagnetic or inductive coupling is also there in this third case. Now suppose this in the evaluate phase, suppose this output should remain at 1. The combination of X is such that at a particular evaluate cycle, this F, the output here, should remain at 1. And during the same instant of time, either one of these lines or many of these lines are making a transition from 1 to 0. It may happen so because it's a big circuit. When during the particular evaluate cycle, this output node should remain at 1 because this is the combination of X for that during that particular instant. Unfortunately, during the same instant, one or many, even I am showing only three, but there may be a good number of such crossing lines or mutually coupled lines, okay? And some of them may make a transition during the same instant, which is from 1 to 0 means VDD to 0 volt. 1 to 0 means VDD to 0 volt. So what will happen as a result? Because of this capacitive coupling here, this charge, which was held here, because you know that during the pre-charge phase, it was fully charged. And in the evaluate phase, the overall situation was such that F offered an open circuit. F offered an open circuit, the charge was retained. That is why the state 1 was maintained. But now, in the same instant, various lines crossing this particular line, they are making a transition from 1 to 0. So as a result, because of this 1 to 0 means it becomes 0. So this point, so there will be a capacitive transfer of charge from this to this momentarily, because this normally happens during the clock pulse duration. And as a result, there will be some undesirable glitches 1 to 0, this kind of glitches somewhere occurring. There may not be full depletion of glitches, or in certain cases, you know that it may not go to the full charge in certain case. Sorry, normally this is suppose the eval pre-phase, pre-charge case, pre-charge. Okay, this is the pre-charge time. And then you have applied your clock pulse like this. This is your 5, okay? From here to here it was pre-charge. And then there is an evaluate mode, evaluate cycle. Okay? Now the output was supposed to be at 1, but then at the same instant, or it will be a little bit delayed. Normally, you know that I shall be discussing that. There will be some delays always involved. There will be some quick, for a very short time, this thing may go to 0, and as a result, what may happen, that some charges will be lost. In certain very few cases, it may happen like this. In certain other cases, the charge may be almost lost like this, because there is nobody to replenish the charge, because this is off. VDD is isolated. That is the problem. During the evaluate phase, this transistor remains off. If this particular node somehow loses charge undesirably, then charge will be permanently lost. And as a result, voltage will fall. So these effects are totally undesirable, and one should do to prevent this. This is one problem. The second problem appears, and that is a very major problem, and it is as follows. Suppose we have a combination like this. So this is a situation when two pre-charge CMOS logic stages have been cascaded. One is producing F1 inverse, the other is producing F2 inverse. Please note that F1, M2 are the two functional blocks. The inputs are the word X, the N bit, or in general, a set of input variables. Similarly, Y is a set of another set of input variables. Maybe the same set or one set, you do not know. The functions are different. And then you want to cascade them to generate F2, which is a function of not only Y, but also the output derived from the first stage. So F2 bar, the complement of F2, is a function of not only the set of variables y, but also the output from the first stage. So you see that all these PMOSes, all these load transistors, they are connected, and all these NMOSes, the driver transistors, they are connected, and they are connected to the common signal, which I am calling phi or the clock pulse. That is what that is one simplicity. There is no question of using no necessity of using any two-phase, three-phase kind of clock. A simple single clock, one clock operation. Now your situation is like this. This is your clock pulse. This is phi. This is the precharge time, precharge cycle, and this is your evaluate circuit. And then it goes back like this. Suppose the combination X is such that during a particular evaluation cycle, this output, I am calling this point as say P and this point as Q, the node P should make a transition, should be zero. During a particular evaluate cycle, the node P should be zero, whereas the node Q should be one. This is my choice. The design is such that for a particular combination of X, Y, then in the evaluate phase, P should be zero and Q should be one. That is the desired thing. Now you see that just before the evaluation phase, the node was P charged to VDD. Okay, then the combination here is such that there is somehow a short circuit path between this and this in the evaluate phase, and it becomes zero. But this will take a time because there is always some propagation delay involved with the process. So what will happen? That the signal at P, the voltage at P, earlier to the evaluate phase it was high, because that is how it is defined as precharge phase. It was charged to the full voltage, but then it will fall to zero after a short time delay. This I am calling the propagation delay tau associated with the leading edge. Propagation delay tau associated with the leading edge. So what is going to happen, that though we want that during the entire evaluation cycle, the output P should remain zero, but it cannot happen so because of this small delay involved. For a very short initial time tau, the output P will remain one. Is it all right to all of you? Now this output is going to the gates of a number of transistors in the F2 block. It may happen so that because for a short time the P is high, those transistors whose inputs are derived from P will be conducting, will turn on, and it may be such that the particular combination of Y is such here that there is a short circuit path available between this and this during the short time tau. So what will happen as a result? Again, this point Q was also precharged to VDD during the same precharge cycle, and that charge will be lost. It will discharge through this path. And once it is lost, what I said, there is no mechanism for the replenishment of the charge till the next P charge phase comes. Next, this again phi becomes zero. So what will happen? What is going to happen? So at Q point, what is going to happen? In the precharge phase, it was 1. At Q point, in the precharge phase, it was 1. But our logic design was such that this 1 should have been maintained. Because that is how I define. I said that the combination is such that in the evaluate phase, for the evaluate phase, that means when phi is equal to 1, then I want that this F1 bar should be 0 and F2 bar should be 1. That was my desire. That is how I designed the whole thing. Okay, for the particular combination of X and Y. But in this case, that cannot happen simply because of the loss of charge during the initial small delay tau. And as a result, this thing will fall. And again, of course, during this instant, sorry, I have not shown this. This should again become 0. This is wrong. But I wanted that things should remain like this. This was my, the Q should have been like this only. Should have remained like this. That was the desire. That was the design specification. But instead of that, you see that it turns, it becomes 0 because of the loss of charge. And this is the main problem associated with the so-called precharge CMOS logic. If you want to realize, you want to cascade the precharge CMOS logic stages simply by direct cascading without bothering anything about the consequences which may result out of it, then this kind of malfunctioning of the logic, it may not happen for every cycle, but certain evaluation cycles, you may get something which is abnormal, which is unexpected, which is undesirable. This is not a glitch. In the earlier case, there may be some earlier example, whatever I have shown, there may be a little fall or small glitches sometime due to electromagnetic ringing. This normal, this kind of thing will happen due to the inductive effect. But due to the capacitive effect, there may be a certain fall. As a redistribution of charge, so there is nobody to replenish that charge. That has to be remembered. And that may create some problem, the noise margin may suffer, as I told you. But in this case, it's not that. The certain place where, in the certain time, when I want 1, it becomes 0. That's the entire thing is wrong. And this is the main, as I told you, that, yeah, precharge CMOS logic appears to be a very good alternative to simple NMOS logic. You see that the NMOS logic was the advantage because, that was the main culprit, main drawback of CMOS was higher packing density and smaller delays, etc. Higher delays, etc. But here, because you are using only single transistor, everything is being done with the help of NMOSes. So otherwise, it is excellent. But this is the problem, and I have to solve this problem. And there, people proposed a new logic. In fact, it is derived from the same, which is called domino CMOS logic. Domino, word domino, there is nothing. It is just derived from the game domino. That these sticks are arranged like this. Some are cycle sand. If one cycle falls, one after another, the cycles, Y cycles start falling from one side to another side. Same thing, domino game was there. The sticks were arranged like this, broad sticks, and somebody just puts it down and automatically that is transferred one after another. Something like one, sometimes also called bucket brigade. As you know, that bucket brigade is a little bit different. What is bucket brigade? It's just when transferring water from one side to another side. What do you do? People stand with buckets. The first man puts the water in the first bucket, then it is transferred to the second bucket. It's a serial process. That's how CCDs, etc., charge-coupled devices, they work on the principle of bucket brigade. This is not bucket brigade. I am coming to the why it is called domino. It will be apparent now. What is done now, simply the domino CMOS, you just put, I am sure I'll be drawing, I think there is no need for drawing separately. What I will be doing simply, I will putting an inverter here. At the between two stages, I'll put an inverter. An inverter is put between two stages. And in that case, this is not going to happen. Can you tell me why? Simply, you don't do anything else. Between two stages, you put an inverter. Of course, that will be increasing the number of transistors by two per stage. That has to be, you know, it can't help. But does it help? And that is what is called domino CMOS, simply. You just go on cascading, but between two stages, you connect, you put an inverter, a NOT gate. Now, you have not asked me the other side of this story. That means, suppose I told you the P has to make a transition from 1. That means I said that in the evaluate phase, when phi, this point is 0 and this point is 1, the desirable one, then I have problem. I said that. Was there any problem? Suppose this point was to be at 1 and this point to be at, let us see, either 1 or 0. Let us see. Without this, forget about this inverter. I am referring to the original circuit. Direct coupling. Suppose F1 bar was 1. 1 means, what would I can draw it by another color now, simultaneously. That means in the precharge phase, this is 1. And I want that in the evaluate phase also this should remain 1. And naturally, this is 1. Always in precharge phase, it is 1. And for the other thing, either 1 or I'm coming to the F2 bar point afterwards. Now, in this case, the combination of X is such that during the evaluation phase, this F block, F1 block, offers an open circuit. So though this is closed, does not matter, this is open. So the charge is retained, and there is no fall of voltage as a result. And as a result, exactly that is happening. Do you envisage any problem here? Because you are allowing sufficient settling time during the precharge mode, recharge cycle, for settling down, only excepting for the extra, I told you, normally the basic device delay is very small. It is a delay associated with the transfer of signal from one node to another, so-called RC delays. That is more important. Right? I explained in some earlier class, you remember the basic, only in the most advanced VLSI technology today, some more additional problems are coming because you have come to the age of the technology then. But in most of the other cases, you know that it is the RC delay associated with the transfer of signal from one node to another is more important than the actual switching delay associated with the device. Devices that can be assumed to be intrinsically of much higher speed than the sluggishness offered by the transmission lines connecting the different nodes. That has to be remembered. So what I said that you have allowed sufficient time for settling down this thing. So naturally, there is no question of suddenly it should become zero. This question is not coming, it's not arising at all. And as a result, if one block all these transistors in this situation, naturally all the transistors here whose inputs are derived from P will turn on naturally, that is expected. And that will turn on. Even during the precharge cycle also they were on. Even during the precharge cycle also they were on. So there is no problem. Then output designs, output of this now depends on what is the combination of Y at the particular, during the particular evaluation cycle. If the combination is such that this resultant net resistance between these two is small, this will offer a zero. If the net resistance is very high, open circuit, then this, so there should not be any problem here. So it is understood that if the P is 1, there is no such problem which I indicated in the earlier case when P was 0 in the evaluation phase. Now what has been done, you see that you have now connected a inverter. Now in the precharge phase, this is 1. So during the precharge phase, this is 0. Only thing is, at the start of the, I think I can draw it. Let us draw it here. This is your phi. So I will call it EP. E means evaluate precharge. Evaluate precharge. Evaluate precharge, and so on and so forth. So this instant, this time is evaluation time, and this time is the precharge time. Phi is 0 is precharge, and phi is 1 is evaluate. Now you see that. When you suppose you have got an inverter here, as indicated in the domino CMOS mode, during the evaluation phase, I am again showing the signal at P and the signal at Q for different cases. Now suppose during the evaluation phase here, P might be 0 or 1, you do not know. If it is 0, then during precharge it will become 1, and there is a little delay involved. And then at the point which I should have shown now, that is, I am now putting another point calling P dashed. So I will put some P dashed here first, and then Q. So P dashed, there may be a little delay because this inverter will offer a little more delay, isn't it? Inverter has got a delay associated. So there will be some delay here and little bit more delay at the output of the inverter. So what is going to happen? Can you tell me, suppose P was 0 in the earlier evaluation cycle. P was 0, suppose, in the earlier evaluation cycle here. It was 0. Then you are precharging it. So naturally it will rise to 0. It will be like this. And there will be some delay involved naturally. This cannot be an instantaneous process. Some delay is involved. Or if it was 1, then it will be retained. There is nothing. But what about the P dashed point? What about the P dashed point? Under this situation, it will be inverted. So, but there will be a little bit more delay because inverter offers this some extra delay. So, inverter point, I expect that it will be something like this, and little bit extra delay. So, you see that. It is not important at all what is happening at the edge, at the starting point of the precharge cycle. It is more important what is happening at the start of the evaluation cycle. So you can say just before the evaluation cycle, the inverter output will be in 0 state. There may be some kind of delays involved. But that delay is not mattering me at all because I am interested in what is happening during the evaluation phase. Precharge phase is not at all important to me. During the evaluation phase, you see that this will remain 0. At the start, just before the start of the evaluation phase, it is remaining 0. Now, 0 means the transistors which were driving this output. This output was driving some transistor, they were off. There no question of them remaining on. Now what is happening? Now suppose let us consider the situation when P makes a transition from 1 to 0. So what is going to happen now? P makes a transition from 1 to 0. And naturally, there will be a little delay involved, as I indicated earlier. This is not an instantaneous process. So this is my delay. As before. And then, what is the status now? This will remain 1 for some time, means inverter output will remain 0 for some more time, and little bit more time in fact, because inverter will offer a little bit more delay. So you can say that up to this and maybe little bit more time, inverter will remain 0. If inverter output is 0, is there any problem you are investing? Because I am concerned about more about the loss of charge from this point. Accidental loss of charge from this point during the evaluation phase is totally undesirable, because there is no mechanism for the replenishment of that charge during the evaluate phase. And that no question of that happening here, because you see in this case, sorry, one extra sheet I have taken. Because in this, you see that the P dash remains 0. P dash remains 0 means the transistors are open. So even only if the desired output is to be 0, that is a separate question. Suppose I want that desired output Q should remain 1 during the evaluate phase when P is 0. Then suffering any problem in that, do you envisage that that may happen here in this case? The thing should be like properly understood. It can only, the choice of why is such that yes, the over there is a short circuit path, then it will become that. But that is not, the choice is such, it is so designed that when the inverter output is 0 or 1 0, and y is such a combination that this should remain 1, and there will be no problem in it. On the other hand, if you consider the other situation, when P should be 0, P should remain 1. So before the evaluate pre-charge phase, it was 1. During the next evaluation, evaluate phase, it is 1. So this continues to be in 0, the output continues to be in 0 state during the entire block of time period from pre-charge to evaluation. And then it is the combination of y which will determine the state of the output. There should not be any problem. So the earlier problem which we encountered while directly cascading to pre-charge CMOS stages is totally removed. This problem is totally eliminated simply by putting one inverter in between. In that case, design, you know, that you have to suppose ultimately what is necessary. I think today I don't have much time to discuss. The next class I'll do that. I'll take an example and you can start, I'll give you the problem, you can do yourself, and ultimately I'll discuss that in the same class, in the next class. Ultimately, you know that you have to realize a function. How? It depends on you. There are various approaches. You have to just one thing, you can do the whole thing by using a single block. Because this is one output function. There are many input variables, but there is only one output. So it depends on you, the design. But suppose while it is such a complicated function that the block becomes very, 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 very large and unmanageable. So in that case, what we think normally? We think of fragmenting it into and cascading them. Otherwise, we don't think. Only the question of cascading will come only when we find that the combinational logic is so complex that just by using one block, it is difficult to realize a function. In that case, you just break just our handling matrices. If it is a very large matrix, you partition it and handle it for computational purpose. Same thing we do here. So for that, what has to be done is, you have to take an example, but you know that in the class we cannot handle such very big problem. We are not using any computational aid. What I can do is I can give you a particular example. Suppose you just start with this. You just take it as a problem for the next class and I will discuss it in the same thing. You realize by domino CMOS the following function. A, B, plus CD. Exactly, because I did it earlier. That is why I'm giving it to you. You realize this function by the domino CMOS principle, not by using a single block. Single block, you can always do it, but I am not interested in that, so that to demonstrate the advantage of this domino operation. Why domino? Because you are inverting, inverting, inverting. From one stage, you are inverting it and going to the next stage. That is why it is called being domino. It was originally called domino. There is no other name for it, just like totem pole. Totem pole appears in electronics. Pole is such an important thing, poles and zeros. And the students in the initial stage, they said, think that totem pole is something very new concept kind of. It is nothing but that. Totem pole is, you know, that the tribals use that kind of particular thing. Somehow somebody named it totem pole and it is remaining. Similarly, same thing is for the domino. The person who worked on it, he gave the name domino by seeing its similarity with the domino play game. Okay, there is no other reason for giving the name domino. So this function has to be done. You take it as a problem. I think today, if I continue, I don't have much time. And all right, let me stop here today. Thank you. Acha, tomorrow I think to wait to Tuesday's class. I'll be.